Hello everyone, welcome to lesson 59, in or out. 大家好，今天我们学习第59课。课文的标题呢是进来还是出去， in or out. The text is about a dog who has run away from his master's home and never come back. 课文呢讲的是一条狗从主人家跑了出去以后再也没回来。Okay, let's first take a look at the keywords and expressions. Rex, 这是故事中狗的名字。Bark, press, pull, latch, expert, develop a habit, remove,Annoyed. Okay, as usual, I'm going to give you 3 questions on the text to help you grasp the story. Now, let's look at the screen. Question number 1. Why did the writer's husband spend weeks training the dog to open the front gate? 作者的丈夫为什么花几个星期的时间来训练这个狗自己开大门？ Question number 2. What bad habit has the dog developed? 这条狗养成了一个什么坏习惯？ Question number 3. What happened when the writer's husband removed the gate?当作者的丈夫把门拆掉以后发生了什么事？
Our dog Rex used to sit outside our front gate and bark. Every time he wanted to come into the garden, he would bark until someone opened the gate. As the neighbors complained of the noise, my husband spent weeks training him to press his paw on the latch.To let himself in. Rex soon became an expert at opening the gate. However, when I was going out shopping last week, I noticed him in the garden near the gate. This time, he was barking so that someone would let him out. Since then, he has developed another bad habit. As soon as he opens the gate from outside,He comes into the garden and waits until the gate shuts. Then he sits and barks until someone lets him out. After this, he immediately lets himself in and begins barking again. Yesterday, my husband removed the gate, and Rex got so annoyed, we have not seen him since.
Have you enjoyed the story? Okay.Let's try to answer the questions. 好，下面我们就来试着回答前面提的问题。Why did the writer's husband spend weeks training the dog to open the front gate? 作者的丈夫为什么花几个星期的时间来训练狗开大门？ Because the dog would sit outside the gate and bark until someone opened the gate.And the neighbors complained of the noise. 因为这条狗呢，总是坐在大门外叫个不停，直到有人来开门，而邻居们呢对此呢抱怨不已。What bad habits has the dog developed? 这条狗养成了一个什么坏习惯呢？ Well, as soon as he lets himself into the gate.Into the garden, he begins barking until someone lets himself out, and then he would do the same thing again. 他一把自己放进花园以后呢，他就开始叫个不停，直到有人把他放出去。然后呢，他又把同样的事情再做一遍。What happened?When the writer's husband removed the gate. 当作者的丈夫把门卸走以后，发生了什么？ The dog got so annoyed that he ran away and never came back. 这条狗呢，很恼怒，从此以后呢，就离家出走，再也没回来。Okay, that's it for the questions and answers. Now we move on to the language points. 接下来我们看本科的语言点。Every time he wanted to come into the garden, he would bark until someone opened the gate. 每次他想进花园的时候，他总会叫个不停，直到有人来开门。Every time 这个词组呢，相当于一个连词，它引导出一个时间状语从句，意思是每当怎么样，每次怎么样。我们来看两个例句。Every time I went back to my hometown, I was surprised at the changes. 每次我回家乡，总是对各种变化感到非常惊奇。He brought a present every time he came to visit us. 他每次来看我们，都带来一件礼物。好，我们再看下一个语言点。As the neighbors complained of the noise, my husband spent weeks training him to press his paw on the latch to let himself in. 由于邻居们对狗叫很有意见，所以我丈夫花了几个星期的时间训练狗用爪子按住门闸把自己放进来。 Complain of 意思是对什么东西抱怨，也可以说 complain about。这里有一个固定的说法，花时间做某事，要说 spend time doing something， 这里呢要用现在分词。我们来看一些例句。 I spent a whole day writing postcards， 我花了一整天的时间来写明信卡。如果说在什么事情上花时间呢，英文中要说 spend time on something， 请看这个例句。 He has spent a lot of time on this project， 他在这个项目上花了不少时间。这个句子中还有一个表达式要注意一下， let oneself in， 意思是放自己进去。我们来看几个例句。 The door was openSo I let myself in. 门开着，所以呢，我就自己进去了。He opened the door and let me in. 他打开门，让我进去。那么 ，let oneself in 是让自己进去 ，let oneself out 就是让自己出来。He let himself out through the window.他是爬窗出来的。好，我们再看下一个语言点。Rex soon became an expert at opening the gate. Rex 很快就变成了开门的能手。Become an expert at doing something 意思是成为做什么事情的专家能手。Expert 这个词呢，常和介词 at、in、on、with 连用。我们来看看以下的例句。She is an expert in teaching small children. 或者 She is an expert at teaching small children. 她是教小孩子的专家。An expert in economics, 经济专家。An expert on foreign affairs, 外交专家。An expert with the needles, 干针线活的能手。好，我们再看下一个原点。 However, when I was going out shopping last week, I noticed him in the garden near the gate.
然而，上个星期，当我正要出去买东西的时候，我发现他待在花园里靠门的地方。
这里呢 ，go out shopping， 出去买东西。同样的结构，我们再来看看几个例子。Go swimming， 去游泳。Go fishing， 去钓鱼。Go picnicking， 去野餐。
This time he was barking so that someone would let him out.
这次他叫呢，是为了让人把他放出去。
So that 引导出一个目的状语从句。
So that 表示为的是怎么样怎么样。我们来看例句。
Please speak up so that the people sitting at the back can hear you.
请大声一点，这样的话，坐在后排的人就能够听见你了。
Can you hurry up a little so that we won't be late again?
你能稍微快一点吗？这样我们就不会再迟到了。
Yesterday, my husband removed the gate, and Rex got so annoyed we have not seen him since.
昨天我丈夫把门给拆掉了。Rex 很生气。此后呢，我们便再也没有见到他。
Since 是一个时间副词，它的意思是打那以后、此后，经常和完成时态连用。这里是现在完成时。
另外，在这里呢，有一个 so that 的结构，也就是如此怎么样，以至于怎么样。在这个句子中 ，that 被省略了，也就是在 annoyed 后面应该有一个 that。那么这种省略呢，经常是出现在口语中。
来看一个例句 ：He was so excited he could not say anything。
他激动的什么话也说不出来。这里呢也是省略了 that， so excited 后面省略了 that。 在下面的关键句型中，我们要向大家介绍一下表示目的的几种说法。在英语中，表示目的的连词通常有这些
to， in order toSo as to, so that, in order that.
好，我们来看句子。
My husband spent weeks training him to press his paw on the latch to let himself in. This time, he was barking so that someone would let him out.
这两个都是课文中的句子。
We started out early in order to avoid traffic.
为了不赶上堵车，我们早早的就出发了。这里是 in order to.
I moved to the front of the bus so as to get a good view of the countryside.
我挪到了车的前方，以便更好的欣赏乡村景色。这里用的是 so as to.
He left the letter on the table in order that I might see it.
他把信放在桌上，好让我看见它。这里呢是 in order that. 好，又到了结束语的时间了。这篇课文讲的是一条狗，名叫 Rex。大家知道，狗是人类最好的朋友。
A dog is man's best friend.
狗对主人的忠实呢，也是世人皆知的。但是故事中的 Rex 却有些不同。
So why do you think Rex finally disappeared?
那么你觉得 Rex 为什么最后会失踪呢？
I think he disappeared because he resented his master,
who spoiled his pleasure. 我想可能是 Rex 怨恨他的主人破坏了他的一大乐趣。
One possible explanation for his strange habit is that he demands attention.
我们知道在故事中 Rex 有一个怪习惯。对此一种可能的解释是他需要人的注意。
Okay, two more questions before we end the lessons. Do you keep any pets?
你养宠物吗?
Have you seen any pets that have strange habits?
你有没有见过有一些怪癖习惯的宠物呢?
All right, that's it for today's session. See you next time.